Well, welcome everyone, and happy early Thanksgiving. For most of us, Thanksgiving means a lot of food, and it means a lot of fat. And according to some sources, that can equal 3,000 calories just in one meal. And when we look at the fat, 150 grams of fat, put that in perspective, that would be like 30 teaspoons or about 2/3 of fat. Better visual might be a stick of butter plus 2 tablespoons, all in one meal. So pretty significant. Now, for some of us, that can leave us feeling super full, unrealistically, and potentially leave us with heartburn. And for those who are suffering from GERD, this could be a complete disaster. So you might ask, well, what is GERD? What GERD is, it is a severe and chronic expression of the symptoms of heartburn. So if you've ever felt that burning sensation right behind your breastplate, maybe it went up your neck a little bit into your esophagus, maybe it felt like a tightening around your chest. These would be some of the symptoms of acid reflux, and then when it's severe and chronic, like 2 months or 3 months, then it is classified as GERD. So it's very, very problematic for many people. Now, for most people, or in many cases, this can be managed with losing a little bit of weight, if we stop smoking, if we cut back or stop drinking alcohol. It can also be managed by cutting back on fatty foods and avoiding spicy or acidic foods. So, today, you know, we can talk about ways that you can defat your holiday dinners, but you probably want to reach out to me personally for that. You can walk through your Thanksgiving menu and look for ways to cut out fat, but keep the flavor. That's a one-on-one conversation. Today, we're going to talk about the cranberry relish that normally appears on the Thanksgiving table. And now, for people with GERD, this can be an absolute menace. So, I came up with this really fantastic substitution. It is a carrot fennel fig chutney. And I love it because it focuses on low acid foods. It is low fat. It includes the use of spices, actually a lot of them, but of the non-irritating kind. And it represents a lot of diversity that you can enjoy on your Thanksgiving table, but also as a leftover that you can enjoy for the couple days that follow. So let's get started. I've got my pan heating here on my burner. And this just begins with adding a little bit of liquid. I've got pre-measured some water. I have some apple cider vinegar, which I know is an acid, but scientific evidence shows that some people who are able to tolerate vinegar, this can actually help close the lower esophageal sphincter. And I'll explain that to some people. This is actually very helpful. With that being said, if you know that vinegar is one of those acid items that disturbs, that is an irritant for you, absolutely, you're going to want to omit drinking regular water. So, vinegar goes in, and I have pre-cut some carrots, about 3/4 of a cup, those go in, fennel, that goes in, as well as our figs. I, again, pre-cut them, remove the stems, and this is going to heat here in our pot. There. While that is heating, I want to share with you a couple of things as we go forward. So you might be asking, so why is GERD so serious? I mean, obviously you've got burning sensation through your lower esophageal sphincter and esophagus. That's going to be very painful. But it's also important because let me first start by explaining what's happening. So we have our esophagus that goes down to our stomach, and between the esophagus and the stomach is a sphincter, which is nothing more than something like a muscle that acts like a rubber band, and when it closes, it keeps the food and acid in your stomach, and when it opens, it can, if it's too loose or perhaps it's not functioning correctly, up through the esophagus, and that is what causes the burning sensation. Obviously, that can be very painful, but it can also damage your esophagus. It can even come so far up as to damage the enamel on your teeth, causing bad breath. And, obviously, it can be painful and can develop into a chronic cough. These would be some of the symptoms. Now, as I mentioned, let's get our spices in here before I go on to tell you a little bit more about how to manage this. You just need a little bit, you're going to love these spices, because this is what's going to make our carrots, fennel, and figs a wonderful, wonderful flavor. It's going to start off with a quarter teaspoon of coriander, which you might be familiar with. That's nothing more than brown cilantro seeds. And it's going to take a bit of ginger, which has been shown scientifically to help ease upset stomachs and be very soothing, and potentially could help GERD as well. And then it's going to take some cardamom, a much smaller amount. If you've got a 16th of a tablespoon of a teaspoon, then you're in luck. Otherwise, you're just going to have to guesstimate what this might be. A little bit of cardamom. I love cardamom because it's going to have a little bit of from the coriander, and then a little bit of allspice. This is going to give it just that wonderfulness that's in the cake. Add that in. And finally, I'm including a bit of fennel seeds, because again, scientifically, looking at the evidence, there has been some evidence that shows that chewing on fennel seeds can actually release an oil that can help our lower esophageal sphincter close. So pretty cool. So add those in. This is just going to make a wonderful aromatic combination. And while that heats, it gives me a chance to share with you just a few more tidbits, because I know a lot of people are wondering, well, why didn't you build this presentation about GERD with the inclusion of cranberries? And one of my inspirations was I found a piece of research, and actually it was in the nutrition, it was at FNC, and it was presented there, and I thought it was very significant because it talks about all stomach ulcers, which are caused by a very contagious bacteria, what happens is this bacteria normally can burrow through the mucus lining that protects our stomachs, and when it gets through, it actually causes an ulcer, or it can cause an ulcer. And what the research has shown is that when that ulcer forms, it can actually cause a couple different problems. One, upper GI cancer, but secondly, GERD could be one of the problems that could result. And by drinking cranberry juice, it actually prevents the bacteria from adhering to the intestinal wall, right where that mucus is, and it prevents the bacteria from growing through. So pretty cool stuff. And I wanted to share that with you because it's always nice to get those tidbits and just research that's on us. Where science is going. Now, for most of us, we've experienced heartburn before. And probably don't want to get it again. So the whole idea of looking for ways to cut back on fat, looking for ways to maybe moderate the amount of acid that we eat, this recipe, this carrot fennel fig recipe for chutney, is just going to be a wonderful addition to your holiday meals. All right. Wow, it smells so good. Put that aside. I know many of you are waiting to find out who the winner is for our raffle. And I'm going to step forward for this because I have put your names into a wheel. And when I punch the wheel, it's going to spin. We'll find out together who is the winner. Okay. Victoria. So we'll be in touch with Victoria and let her know that she is the winner of the plant-based challenge raffle. Pretty exciting stuff. All right, so at this point, we have the ingredients in there. It is then cooking away, and we are ready to actually give this a quick little mash so that it becomes either a chutney or a sauce. So I have simplified, no need to get out the immersion blender or other cooking processor. You can just use your regular potato masher. And give this a swish or two. Oh, I cannot tell you how great this looks. You're going to love it, and I'll show you several different ways that you can enjoy this. Alright, we have the spices in there. It smells absolutely heavenly. It has been cooking away for about maybe 7 minutes. You might want to let yours cook for 10 or 12 minutes. To this, I am going to go ahead and stir in the sugar so that becomes nice and incorporated again over the heat. This is going to thicken, and in the last minute, I will add just that little touch of vanilla, because vanilla is 35% alcohol. You might want to eliminate this if you know that alcohol bothers GERD. On the other hand, it adds a nice flavor, and as this boils away, some of that alcohol is also going to evaporate. All right. Awesome. Let me serve this up. And I want to share with you a few things, because I know a lot of you are juggling health issues and wondering how to manage your health issues through the holidays. And when you're at home, what's really great is you're the host, so you can't control what lines are on the table. And that might mean telling your guests what you want them to bring. And it might include reading labels, making sure that you focus on whole foods or minimally processed foods. Now, on the other hand, many of you are also traveling for the holidays, and if this happens to you and you're wondering, okay, how do I manage, you know, my health issue or GERD, when I'm on, you know, going to someone else's health, communicate with that host, offer your help. See if you can't bring a dessert or a side dish or maybe even an appetizer, something that you know that you can eat. Alright, let me let you take a peek at this. Isn't it really colorful? It's really beautiful, huh? It's got that beautiful aroma of all those spices coming together. It's really, really gorgeous. But I really also want to do it because Thanksgiving, the holidays, this type of chutney, it's not just about one time you get to enjoy it on the table. It's about the leftovers too, right? So it will go great with your mashed potatoes, with your turkey, whatever you choose to have for Thanksgiving. But I thought I would share with you just a couple leftover ways that are just going to be scrumptious. So we've got the grape chutney. You can also pair that with, I've got several whole wheat crackers. You can dip apple or pear slices into it. I've got some low-fat cheese that would make a nice combination. And to kind of bring it all together, one of the things I thought would be helpful, I've got some almond butter, I've got a smear on the cracker, and then put the chutney right on top. How cool is that? Now, if you're thinking, what else can this chutney go with? That covers maybe a couple snacks, maybe a farmer-style lunch. You could also toss this with an arugula salad. I've got some arugula here. This would be just a beautiful way to use your chutney. Of course, you can use it as a spread on a sandwich or even toss it, not toss it, but screw it into a wrap. It just makes a beautiful, aromatic flavor to your lunch. So, anyway, I wanted to share these ideas with you. Just lots of leftover ideas coupled with this great accompaniment for your Thanksgiving dinner. I hope you guys all have a fantastic Thanksgiving.
Libby, I do have a question for you that came in through the chat. Someone wanted to know how long can it be refrigerated for, and also can it be frozen?
Okay, Great question. Freezing no problem. It will keep about 3 months frozen. A little bit longer since it does not have meat in it. You do want to package it in an airtight container and label that and date it so you don't lose it in the back of the in the freezer. As far as refrigeration goes, it can keep certainly several days in the refrigerator. It does have fennel and carrots in it, and you know, so it's going to keep the same duration as the reflux, carrots, and have it as a side dish.
No other questions through the chat, so if anyone has a question and they want anyone themselves to ask Libby, you're welcome to. Otherwise, but lots of nice, thank yous and looks delicious through the chat message, so, and it does.
Awesome. Well, I'm so glad everyone could join me today, and I look forward to seeing you in the, through the holidays.